रीडिंग एंड मेकिंग मैप्स। व्हाट इज ए मैप? ए मैप इज ए रिप्रेजेंटेशन और ए ड्राइंग ऑफ द टोटल और ए पार्ट ऑफ द अर्थ सरफेस ड्रॉन ऑन द फ्लैट सरफेस अकॉर्डिंग टू ए स्केल। Maps present information about the world in a simple visual way. They show the shapes of countries, location of water bodies or mountains, and distance between places. Maps can also show the layout of a single city's streets. Tourists use road maps to plot routes for their trips. City planners use maps to help them decide where to put hospitals and parks. Who prepared maps? Map makers, called cartographers, create maps for many different purposes. The art of making maps is called cartography. Someone who makes maps is called a cartographer or cartologist. Gerardus Mercator was the first to publish a collection of maps in the form of a book. What is an atlas? An atlas is a reference tool used to learn about the world. It is a book of maps and information about countries. The name atlas comes from the Greek god Atlas, who was so strong that he was able to carry the world on his shoulder. What are the uses of maps? Maps tell us several things about different places, where they are, whether they are on the sea or on a mountain or in a desert, how hot or cold or rainy they are, what kind of trees and plants grow there, what kind of people live there, the language they speak, the work they do, their settlements, etc. Maps are helpful to us in many ways. Maps help us to study a part of the earth. Maps provide more information than a globe. Maps are easy to carry and take the measurement too. Some maps are tell us about how high or low the places are. Some tells us about how much it rains there or how hot or cold it gets there. Some maps tell us about crops that grow there or the kinds of forest there are. We can know many details about a place from maps. But we cannot show everything on one map. So we can use different maps to know many details about a place. What are some different types of maps? The maps are different types. They are political maps, physical maps, historical maps, thematic maps, etc. Some maps show boundaries between countries, states, as well as the location of national and state capitals and other major cities. They are called political maps. Some maps show the physical features such as mountains, plateaus, plains, rivers, and valleys of an area. These are called physical maps. Maps are also drawn to show the distribution of rainfall, forests, crops, minerals, industries, etc. What are the important features of a map? The following features are very important to make a map. They are direction, scale, color, and symbol. What is a direction? Direction is used to determine where things are in relation to other things. We follow four major directions. They are north, south, east, west. Maps follow a system to show the directions. Usually, maps are prepared in such a manner that north is at the top of the map and south is at the bottom. Therefore, east is on the right and west is on the left. The direction on a map can also be shown by an arrow which is marked N. This shows the north direction. In some special cases, maps may be made with south on the top or on the left. However, in such cases, a special mention will be made on the map and an arrow will be given showing north. Once we know where north lies, it is easy to find the other directions. We can also mark subdirections on a map. They are northeast, northwest, southeast, southwest. Scale, the second feature of the map. We cannot make maps showing the actual size of a place. Hence, we draw a map according to scale. Scale on a map is important in order to give the map reader a sense of size. Maps are just about always smaller than what they really represent, and scale is a way of quantifying how much smaller they are. What is a scale? Scale is the ratio between actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. We use scale to show the actual distance on the ground by reducing it on a map. Maps always mention the scale they use, and we can find out the actual distance between places using the scale. Scale can be expressed in different ways. Example, statement scale. Here the scale is stated in words such as 1 centimeter to 1 kilometer, like a simple statement. As per the simple statement scale, we know that if we measure 1 centimeter, the distance between two places on the map, the real distance on the ground is 1 kilometer. Example of a sketch map between Mehboob Nagar and Vanaparthi. The actual distance between Vanaparthi and Mehboob Nagar is 50 kilometers. The distance on the map is 5 centimeters. 5 centimeters value is 50 kilometers. As per the simple statement scale, we know that if we measure 1 centimeter as the distance between two places on the map, the real distance on the ground is 10 kilometers according to this sketch map. Why do we use symbols on the map? We know that maps are too small for us to draw pictures of the things show on them. For example, we cannot draw the real school or bus stand as it will take too much space on the map. Therefore, we always show things on a map with the help of symbols. Map makers prepare symbols appropriate to their needs. But some common symbols, which are called conventional symbols, are also used. Conventional symbols are widely accepted signs or sign systems which signify an idea or concept. They represent different features on a map and are not drawn to scale. They are important because symbols can be used to depict features like cities, roads, and railways. For example, the land boundary of a country is shown by thick dashes and dots in black color. A city is marked by a small circle or point. To show the river Godavari, we draw a line along its course. For the railway line, we will draw a track line to represent it. In Telangana map, if we want to show the area of Hyderabad district, we demarcate its boundary and mark it with some color or pattern, which is known as a real symbol. Colors on a map. Different colors are used to show things on a map. Generally, maps follow a common scheme of colors. This color scheme is used for maps all over the world. To understand the color scheme, a key is made on the map. A key shows the height of land or depth of water above or below the sea level and the color used to show it on the map. We can use different colors for different geographical features. Example, dark brown for mountains, yellow color for hills and plateaus, green for plains, light blue for shallow waters, dark blue for deep waters.